So your code is already deployed in an Azure Static Web App, but you would like to add an API. In this video, I will show you how you could do that with Visual Studio Code. I'm Frank Boucher, and today we're talking about Azure Static Web App. So when it's time to create Azure function, there's multiple ways to do it. I want to show you how you could do it simply using the Azure Visual Studio Code. I use this tool just because it's cross-platform, it's free, and I think you already may be using it. So in Visual Studio Code, what we'll be doing will be leveraging the extension Azure. So that's the one here with the new logo. I hope you liked it. I like it. So we'll go there, we'll create a function. So now we'll create a project to get started. So I'll click on the first icon and I will browse to my folder. So here I already have a folder. This is my folder of my app. So I already have an API folder, it's empty, so I will use that. And because I do that, it will be creating a project named API because it takes by default the name of the folder. If you want to change that, you could totally do that. I will just keep it that way since it's a demo. I want to use C#. I could mix if I want JavaScript, C#, whatever. There's no problem with that. But for this demo, I'm staying in C#. Voila, I will use .NET Core. And for now, let's skip it, creating the function. Take a few seconds. And now if I look to my code, we'll see that in my folder API, I already have some structure that is there. Perfect. But now we want to add our HTTP trigger. I will use HTTP trigger because that's how I will be calling my function from my app. So I'll go back in our extension, and this time, instead of the little folder, I will create here with the little lightning bolt, create a function. I will, like I said, create an HTTP trigger. I'll give it a name. Just hello seems good for now. And you know what? Let's give a domain name. So we'll just do demo function. Security, and we'll go at the function level. So voila, that's our function. And now just to make it a little bit ours, let's change it. So instead of hello, I will say bonjour, hi. That's a greetings I'm using often. Voila, so now the function is there. It's customized, so we know it's ours. What we need to do now is call that function. So let's open the code. So we'll close here that API. I will open this. And you know what, in the page counter, there's already some code here. So let's implement a new button that will call our function. So to do that here, I will just add the new paragraph. If we look here, I have my new paragraph and I will add the button that will call the function getMessage. And now we'll add this code. So let's zoom to have a look. So very simply here, I have my variable message with a default value hi. And every time I will be calling that message, we'll be calling our function that we just create called just hello, passing the variable name in the query stream. And now we see it's complaining because it doesn't know HTTP. So let's add it, just going on the top of the page and doing an inject HTTP client. And there it is. So I will commit and push that in a different branch. So this way we'll be able to see our changes without committing in the main branch. If you don't know what I'm talking about, you should totally see the previous video where I show you exactly how to do that leveraging the CI/CD supported in Azure Static Web App. I will do that and I will join you just after. Voila, all the checks have been set in our PR or pull request inside GitHub. So now let's click on this link here. I will open that in a different tab, just like this. So we see our application is just deployed and it's a different URL from our main. That's wonderful. And if we go now in counter, we have our new button. And if I click on that, we see here, bonjour, hi, Cloudies. So we just from a web assembly, so C# on client side, called an Azure function, still in C#, all that from Azure Static Web App. I hope that helped. Stay tuned to learn more.